In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Yamet, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
It is Friday, the 11th of November, 2022. 32nd week in ordinary time, and today we remember Saint Martin of Tours, born in 316 AD in Savaria, Pannonia, and died on 8th November 397 in Candace, Gaul. Saint Martin of Tours was born into a pagan family. He was forced to join the army as a teenager. Later, St. Martin received baptism and gave up his career as a soldier. He was ordained by St. Hilary and lived as a hermit. In 361, he established the first monastery in Gaul. In 371, he became the Bishop of Tours. He always gave the example of a good shepherd, founding new monasteries, instructing and preaching the gospel to the poor. Participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Sharon Mukuka from Lusaka, Zambia, celebrating her birthday today, takes for us the first reading. Valentino Mgabaraduku Uyaka from Wau, South Sudan, celebrating his birthday today, takes for us the responsorial psalm. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Godwin Apesu from Lafia Diocese in Nigeria. Let us pray. O God, who are glorified in the Bishop St. Martin, both by his life and death, make new, we pray, the wonders of your grace in our hearts, that neither death nor life may separate us from your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. He who abides in the doctrine has both the Father and the Son. A reading from the second letter of St. John. 2 John, verses 4 to 9. Elect Lady, I rejoice greatly to find some of your children following the truth, just as we have been commanded by the Father. And now I beg you, Lady, not as though I were writing you a new commandment, but the one we have had from the beginning, that we love one another. And this is love, that we follow his commandments. This is the commandment, as you have heard from the beginning, that you follow love. For many deceivers have gone out into the world, men who will not acknowledge the coming of Jesus Christ in the flesh. Such a one is the deceiver and the antichrist. Look to yourselves, that you may not lose what you have worked for, but may win a full reward. Anyone who goes ahead and does not abide in the doctrine of Christ does not have God. He who abides in the doctrine has both the Father and the Son. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, Psalm 119, verse 1, verse 2, verse 10, verse 11, verse 17, verse 18. Response is taken from Psalm 119, verse 1b. And the response is, blessed are those who walk in the law of the Lord.
Blessed are those who walk in the law of the Lord.
Blessed are those whose way is blameless, who walk in the law of the Lord.
Blessed are those who walk in the law of the Lord.
Blessed are those who keep his decrees. With all their hearts they seek him.
Blessed are those who walk in the law of the Lord.
I have sought you with all my heart. Let me not stray from your commands.
Blessed are those who walk in the law of the Lord.
I treasure your word in my heart, lest I sin against you.
Blessed are those who walk in the law of the Lord.
Deal bountifully with your servant, that I may live and keep your word.
Blessed are those who walk in the law of the Lord.
Open my eyes, that I may see the wonders of your law.
Blessed are those who walk in the law of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 17, verse 26 to verse 37. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "As it was in the days of Noah, so will it be in the days of the Son of Man. They ate, they drank, they married, they were given in marriage, until the day when Noah entered the ark, and the flood came and destroyed them all. Likewise, as it was in the days of Lot, they ate, they drank, they bought, they sold, they planted, they built. But on the day when Lot went out from Sodom, fire and brimstone rained from heaven and destroyed them all. So will it be on the day when the Son of Man is revealed. On that day, let him who is on the housetop with his goods in the house not come down to take them away. And likewise, let him who is in the field not turn back. Remember Lot's wife. Whoever seeks to gain his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life will preserve it. I tell you, in that night, there will be two men in one bed. One will be taken and the other left. There will be two women grinding together. One will be taken and the other left." And they said to him, "We are Lord." He said to them, "Where the bed is, there the eagles will be gathered together." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
For today and tomorrow, we are reading from two of the letters of St. John, because the message that is contained in the first letter of St. John is also contained in the second letter of St. John, the message of love. So we somehow leave out the first letter of St. John, which we cover mostly during the Eastertide. And we want to say we leave the first letter now because we are coming to it later. We want just to have the second and third letter of St. John as a bridge to prepare ourselves for the book of Revelation that we are starting on Monday. And who wrote this second and third letter? It was written by an elder, a presbyter. And an elder is somebody who communicates message of importance, especially those of us who are in Africa. We understand the role of an elder and we listen very attentively to elders as they speak to us. And so it is an elder is writing to the chosen lady. Who is this chosen lady? The chosen lady is the church. The church is a she, ecclesia. It is a she. And being a she, we all belong to this she. And we are all recipients of this letter as he writes to us to talk about love and to talk about the heresies. Talk about especially those who deny the flesh. Deny the humanity of Jesus Christ. This was one of the heresies that was going around at that time. And he tackles that problem. In today's reading, we see him repeating what he said in the first letter, that we love one another, and this is love, that we walk according to his commandments. You will never say you love your God if you are not living according to his holy will. Love is not what we utter on our mouths. Even in your own family, don't tell your spouse you love her or you love him. Do it in action. Show it in the way you live your life. That is love. Don't tell your children you love them. Do it in action. Show how much you live with dignity. Show how much you are unable to be at home. How much your children can be proud of you. Show it in your own life. That is love. John says love is shown in action. Love is shown when we truly live by God's commandments. Love is shown when we show that indeed God is all that directs our lives. Then there are people who deny that God came into the flesh. And so he says, for many deceivers have gone out into the world, those who do not confess the coming of Jesus Christ in the flesh. You know what it means not to confess the coming of Jesus Christ in the flesh? Is to deny that you are a human being as a believer. Is to say that as a believer, you can't even enjoy anything. Because Jesus was not human. He was just pretending to be human. Jesus never pretended to be human. He was found among sinners, even eating with them. And in fact, they called him a glutton. In fact, Jesus was found drinking at a wedding. He even made wine. Jesus was human. He shed a tear at the death of Lazarus in chapter 11 of the Gospel of John. Jesus was human. He slept on that boat because he got tired. And these are the things we don't stress. Why? Because many of us want to look at Jesus as superhuman. No, he was a human being. He even sweated blood in the garden because it was too heavy on him and he had fear. And these are the things that makes him to sympathize with us. These are the things that makes Jesus to feel with us. When we show our weaknesses, when we display how human we are, and he laughs, he smiles and says, my son has realized that he is able to fall. My daughter has realized that she's limited. Many of us don't want to accept the humanity of Jesus Christ. That is why it is very difficult for us even to confess our sins when we go wrong, because we think it is incompatible with being a believer. No, Jesus was human and he accepted whatever pertains to being human, only that he did not sin. He did not sin. And so he knows we can sin. He knows we can go away from the face of God. And whenever we do, we realize that he understands. We get back to him. We confess our sinfulness. We turn back to his path. That is how we recognize the humanity and divinity of Christ. The gospel passage of today talks about preparedness. How we have to be prepared in our lives as believers, because the day of the Lord finds us sometimes when we don't even expect it. And so Jesus talks to his disciples saying, as it was in the day of Noah, so will it be in the days of the Son of Man. They were eating and drinking and marrying and being given in marriage until the day when Noah entered the ark. Everything looks normal in our lives. There is no one who can claim to know when his or her day is coming, because nobody knows what it feels like to come to an end. Those who die don't come back to tell us exactly how they felt when they were coming to an end. So it is unexpected. Since it is unexpected, Jesus is telling us only to do one thing. To always live like we are going to die tomorrow, but work like we will never die. Because we are working for the future generation. Because we are working for our children's children. And so we should live like we are going to die tomorrow, always prepared, always making sure that we go for confession, always making sure that we are clean enough to face heaven. We give glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Friday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And I'm desperate for you. And I'm lost without you. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my daily. Your bed.